Here is how I became a principal architect with less than 2 years experience. I want you to know that you can do this too. You too can build the tech career of your dreams, where you earn more than you ever thought possible, are highly respected, and are seen as a leader in your field. And if you're already working, these same tech career secrets will get you promoted and fast-track your career success. I have had an incredible 25-year technology career, but what I've loved most is helping people get their first tech jobs, accelerate their tech careers, and increase their salaries. And I will show you how I became a principal architect in less than 2 years, and how you can be seen as an expert just like me. First, I will tell you my story, and then I will tell you how you can do the exact same thing. I'm not from tech. In fact, I started my career in internal medicine, which taught me three main lessons. The first lesson that I learned is that you cannot be an expert on everything. The second lesson that I learned is you must have deep knowledge in your specialty and know how to build a team. Third, you must be able to communicate and sell your ideas and capabilities to others. When I started being a network engineer, that was the tech career with the highest salary. And I knew this was the career I desired, especially since I like connecting people and computer systems together. Now, I knew nothing about networking, so I asked 50 tech recruiters, what are the characteristics of the perfect network engineer? The kind of engineer that an employee would hire on the spot and pay them anything they desired. Now, what I did is I personally spoke to over 50 recruiters, and I looked for common themes throughout the anomalies and created a list of things to master. I then took this list and looked at what were my strengths and what were my weaknesses. And I created a plan to highlight my strengths and why they would be an asset to my employer, and I fixed my weaknesses. Next, I built a plan to be the best at only the most critical skills and chose not to worry about the non-essential skills. Remember, I learned from medicine that you cannot be an expert on everything. I went on my first interview and was hired as a senior network engineer at the world's largest internet service provider with zero experience. I then asked my manager what it would take to be the best and rise to the top of the organization. And he said, Mike, be the best at these three technologies, OSPF, BGP, and complex routing. He then said, I want you to become a Cisco certified internet expert. He said, look, I don't care at all about certifications, but if you pass this one, we will get a major discount on our service plans from Cisco, and that will make you much more valuable. So guess what I did? Every day after work, I studied OSPF, BGP, complex routing, and the CCIE study materials. 3 months later, I was working as a network architect, and 6 months later, I was a Cisco certified internet expert. Now, while I loved my manager, MCI WorldCom was not exactly the best employer. So I went to Wall Street and became a senior network architect with less than 1 year experience. I had a job that paid me almost $200,000 a year over 20 years ago. That's the equivalent of $330,000 in today's dollars after being adjusted for inflation. I stayed there for 1 year and moved to a wonderful company called Riverstone Networks. They are now Nokia. When I got there, my manager told me that he needed me to become a multicast expert. And I said, you got it. I locked myself in a room for a month, read every publication, every Internet Engineering Task Force request for comments on IP multicast, and I read about 15,000 pages of material that month. I took incredible notes. I practiced explaining it, and then I wrote an article called Intro to Multicast. Now, I poured my heart and soul into this document. I drew 50 plus graphics, and I wanted to make sure that it would be incredible, and I worked to do so. I submitted my document to the company, and it was published everywhere. Within a month, I was traveling all over the world, teaching IP multicast to the world's largest internet service providers, systems engineers, architects, and even teaching business executives how this technology could enhance their business performance. 6 months later, I was a principal architect. What did I do every day? I lived, ate, and breathed IP multicast. I dreamed about IP multicast in my sleep and how it could improve business performance. Now, here's how you can do the same and become a principal architect very quickly, just like me, or rise to the top of your career. Now, don't be scared. Not everyone is willing to lock themselves in a room for 30 days straight, but you can spread it over 3 months if you desire, or you can take a program like ours. We give you exactly what you need to know with nothing you don't need to know, so there's no waste to minimize the time needed to get you to expert status. How do I know you can be successful like this? Well, I've been in tech now for over 25 years, and I have mentored countless technology professionals for over 2 decades, and most of them are now in elite, high-paying roles. I am the CEO of GoCloud Careers, and almost every day I have a student that gets a job that pays them between $120,000 and $300,000 per year. And I'm going to share these tech career secrets with you. My first tech career secret is this. You cannot learn everything in one lifetime, so don't try. You can only be an expert at one thing. This is the single greatest mistake affecting technology professionals. They're trying to learn it all. Don't be the 10x AWS certified person that's bad at everything. Instead, be like Usain Bolt, Simone Biles, or Michael Phelps, the best in the world. You need to be a world champion to stand out, like Michael Phelps, who's the fastest swimmer in the world, and not a Swiss Army knife that does a bunch of things poorly and nothing well. If you want to be elite at anything and have the best tech career with the highest paying jobs, you need the best, and you need to be the best. That means you need to be in the top 5 to 10% of your field. Now, all of you can be in the top 5 to 10% of your field if you do the following things. Pick a specialty. This specialty should meet a few objectives. The first one, it's a highly in-demand skill for which there's a shortage of highly capable people. That affects your salary. It's the simple economic supply and demand curve. The next thing is you have to pick something you love, something that you are fascinated by, and something that you will be thrilled to learn. Next, don't let anything or anyone get in your way. You need to be great at your specialty. There is always something new to learn in tech, and lots of it are exciting. Leave that for something else. Focus on being great at your specialty. Usain Bolt can run, but he doesn't train for marathons. He trains to be the fastest man in the world. And that's why he's the fastest man in the world. Next, get credentialed. If there is an expert certification like the Cisco Certified Internet Expert, get it. But do not, under any circumstances, get a bunch of associate certifications or a bunch of unrelated certifications. For example, for an architect, there's no point getting a DevOps certification, a SysOps or maintenance certification, or a developer certification, because we don't do that. And it's diluting your brand. Instead, get things related to architecture. So, don't get 10x AWS certified. This will not only keep you from being an expert, but it's going to destroy your brand, and it's going to show employers that you lack focus. And when you want an expert, you want someone that's focused. Experts have laser-like focus. Now, train to be the best, just like an Olympian. Olympians have the world's best coaches. They get the best training. And I'm telling you right now, the best training won't be on Udemy or any inexpensive platform. Personally, I spent over $40,000 20 years ago just to get my basic tech training. Was it worth it? Well, I was earning over $200,000 a year with less than a few years' experience. So yes, it was worth it. I had a job that paid me the equivalent of $330,000 in today's dollars after being adjusted for inflation with less than 2 years' experience. So guess what? That $40,000 was nothing. It paid for itself many times over, many times over, and many times over. Now, the best kind of training is not going to be from a certification provider. It's going to be from an expert. And this expert will be quoted in numerous magazines, industry publications, and most likely will have had a big title from a major tech organization at some point in their career. Also, while you're at it, follow industry leaders. They're not going to be YouTubers or TikTok people. They're going to be people with a principal title, a director title, a VP title at the leading tech organizations. Watch their presentations, read their white papers, go see them at conferences, and read the articles they produce in major magazines. Next thing I want you to do is read the industry specifications for your area of expertise. For example, in networking, we have the Internet Engineering Task Force request for comments. They're the actual specifications, as well as the materials from the providers themselves. The providers themselves, like AWS, can give you much more factual information on AWS than any service provider who's taking their information and rewriting it where it becomes like a whisper down the lane game. read the documentation from the market leaders, go to their conferences, watch their presentations, and when you go to their conferences, go to the conference booth, meet people, ask questions. Now, the next phase of becoming an elite tech leader as fast as possible is you've got to get your name out there. You've got to make the world see you as that expert. I want you to start with the following. After you've done your research and you've gotten your training and you've gone to your conferences, make your own internal documentation. For everything you learn, make sure you write it down concretely in explicit terms. Make it clear. What is this piece of technology? How does this technology work? And why should an organization use this technology? Meaning, what are the business or industrial applications of this technology? Here's another tech secret. Businesses don't buy technology because they like it. We techies may, but businesses do not. Businesses buy technology for competitive advantage. So, what's in it for the buyers of the technology? That's what you need to do if you want to rise to the top. If all you know is the tech, it's not good enough. You need to know how the tech can be applied. What is the purpose of the technology? So, make sure you understand the business needs of this technology and the problems that it can actually solve. Now, I want you to continue to optimize your internal documentation until it's super clear to you. And you know these materials as well as you know your favorite activity. Now, the next thing I want you to do is master executive communication. You need to be able to communicate this information so clearly and super succinctly. See, it doesn't matter how well you know this information if you can't communicate it simply, as no one will be able to see you as an expert if they can't understand you. And they won't know what's in your head if they can't understand you. So now we need to show the world. So I want you to start making succinct, concrete, and easy to understand LinkedIn posts in your area of expertise. Use 2 to 3 relevant niche hashtags. Don't go crazy with hashtags or you'll activate the spam algorithm and no one's gonna see your post. The next thing that I'd like you to do is to actually start a blog. And on this blog, I don't want you to write what you're learning. I want you to write about how the technology works in depth. And I want you to talk about the business benefits and the future applications of this technology. Now, when you write these blogs, it needs to be professional. Make sure you have 5 to 15 quality citations from respectable sources like Forbes, Information Week, Tech Republic, AWS, Cisco, for example. Don't use other people's blogs. Now, I want you to make the blog look great. Remember, it's how people are going to see you. Leave plenty of space on the page to make sure it's easier to read. Use simple and easy to understand plain language. Now, it's been said that a picture's worth 1,000 words, so I want you to use professional graphics. Either make them for yourself in your favorite drawing program, something like Lucidchart, Draw.io, or Canva, and maybe make them look great. Or, if you're not great with graphics, hire an expert graphic designer, and you can find someone on Fiverr or Upwork that can make you some desired graphics at a relatively low cost. But whatever you do, make it look great. Personally, I have 2 professional graphics designers, and they take on the graphics for everything that I write. Now, when you write this document, make sure you write it for the correct audience. Your correct audience are tech leaders, people that can hire you for elite technology positions. You're not looking to impress a bunch of techies, as they have no hiring authorities. You need to impress the people that have the juice and the power to get you to your goals. That means you're writing for leadership, and you need to have good leadership skills. So, either take any program of ours where we teach leadership skills, business acumen, sales skills, or get this training from an MBA program. Just learn these skills as they can get you to the top faster, and they'll help you earn several million more dollars over the life of your career. So get these skills. Next, I want you to get published for real. When you start to get a following, start submitting your ideas for publications in major magazines. And when you're published in big media, you'll have real credibility. Guess what? When you're in this phase, people reach out to you every day just to hire you. How important is this for your expert brand? Well, last year I had over 70 articles published in major magazines and TV media. I'm so well known at this point for helping people build elite technology careers that many publications come to me and ask me to write articles for them or be on their radio show. So I want you to speak at conferences. As you write major publications, guess what? People will ask you to speak at conferences and take advantage of this opportunity. It will show the world you're an expert. You'll be flooded with more job offers for high-paying careers. But before you make these presentations, make sure you have elite presentation skills and executive preferences. It will go a long way to enhance your presentations, so either take any of our programs and get this training, or take the training somewhere else. Personally, I've taken over $20,000 of training on presentation skills and executive presence. This kind of training pays major dividends to your, for your career. So get it, either with us or somebody else. Now you know how I became a principal architect in less than 2 years and that you can do the same. Now I have a few more ways to help you and some more videos for you to watch to fast track your career success. First, join me on any of our free webinars and learn how to build the best technology career. And guess what? You can ask me questions live in real time. I would like you to watch the How to Make More Money in Tech video. It will teach you how to make millions of dollars more in your tech career. And if you're looking to get your first cloud architect job, attend our How to Get Your First Cloud Architect Job webinar. The link is in the description below. And if you want to get hired on your next interview, guess what? Attend our next interview webinar. The link will be in the description below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to learn more about building a high-paying elite technology career. I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care, I'll see you soon.